How can I delete an old account if I can't log in? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. How can I delete my old TikTok account if I can't log in? I forgot my email and my password. You probably can't. While the original question refers to a specific service, TikTok, this answer really does apply to almost every free service that you might use. If you can't log in, you can't delete the account. And your options are few. So if you can't log in, you can't delete. What does that mean? Why can't I delete an account? Well, how you log in, your ability to log in, is what proves to that service you're who you say you are. It proves to that service that you are the person who is authorized to delete that account. Think about it. If somebody who couldn't log into the account could delete it, then basically anybody you piss off could delete your account. And not just the old ones, right? They could delete your current accounts. There has to be some kind of authentication to prove that you are the right person who has the authority to delete the account. Signing in or logging into the account is that proof. So, what if you can't sign in? What if you can't log in? Well, there's a process for that. And that process is very simple. Recover your account. It's simple in theory, right? You start with the can't log in, or I forgot my password, or whatever other link there is for that situation on that service's login page. That service will then walk you through a process of attempting to recover your account. They will use other means to attempt to identify you or confirm that you are the right person who should be allowed to delete or sign into this account. Usually that's done by sending a code to an alternate email address you've got registered with the account, sending a message to the phone number associated with that account, using a backup code that you created and saved earlier, any number of different things. If those don't work, in other words, you can't recover access to your account, it's not your account anymore. You can't get in, and that means you can't delete it. There simply is no way around this fact. Everything that I've talked about in terms of account recovery, that all needs to be set up before you lose access to your account. That means that if you're hearing this, if you're seeing this, set up and maintain the account recovery information for your important accounts. You run the very real risk of losing it all if you can't recover the account later because maybe you let an alternate email address expire, or maybe you didn't set one up, or maybe you changed phone numbers and you forgot to change that number in this account. Don't do that. If you find yourself in a situation where you have lost your account forever because you can't log in, please learn from the experience. Make sure that all of the accounts you set up in the future are set up with the appropriate recovery information. In fact, the lesson to be learned here is actually fairly straightforward. Never forget your email address. I realize not everybody uses email addresses for everything. They don't use an email address constantly like some people do. That's fine. Doesn't matter. Remember the email address. You need it. Keep access to that email account. You will need it. Don't let your email address expire from lack of use. That happens a lot, it appears, and that's really unfortunate because you may think you've got yourself covered by having configured an alternate email address or an email address for the account, and then when they send a recovery code to it, well, now you've got a different problem. You can't log into your email address. You can't get the recovery code. Make sure that you check in once in a while, that you keep it up to date, and simply make sure it's there when you need it. Don't forget your password. This sounds so trite, but it's really easy to forget your password, especially since so many services are insisting that you have long, complex, unmemorable passwords. The solution there is very simple. Use a password vault. Quit trying to remember anything other than the single password that unlocks your password vault and have that be the repository for everything else you care about. Set up that recovery information, like an alternate email address or a phone number or recovery codes or whatever else it is that will allow you to get back into your account should you ever forget the credentials or lose access to the account for some other reason. Above all, please take this all seriously. It's so easy to think that, you know, this account, it doesn't matter. Trust me, in 6 months, in a year, it will. You would not believe the number of people that I hear from who start out with an account that they think they're never going to care about. 2 years later, 3 years later, they suddenly find A, they've lost access to it, and B, it turned out to be super important for something that they didn't realize. Take it all seriously. I hope that helps a little bit. I know that I can't get you back into your account if you can't recover it, but please learn from that lesson. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/121900. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.